So we'll continue with the previous session, that is metallic coatings. In previous session, what we learnt is what is anodic protection, how the anodic protection, what is the process of the anodic protection, its advantages, limitations, and its application. Now this is metallic coating. Now very simple, metal is coated with some other metal, that is called as metallic coating. Now before we apply any coating, metallic coating on the metal, the step one is the solvent cleaning. Clean that metal to remove all the oily and greasy material, right? Step one. Step two, we can either use alkali or we can use either acid to clean the surface so that it is free from all types of rust, right? Or any other material which can interfere in the coating process. You can also use a wire brushes or abrasives, scrapes, grinders, etc. for cleaning all the. So before applying this metallic coatings, we need to clean the surface. That is step one. Step two is either treat with the acid or alkali solutions to clean the surface thoroughly. Sometimes flame cleaning also can be used. We can use it for just cleaning purpose, right? We can just heat the metal and then we can use sand blasting process for cleaning. Now actually, what is the method? This is the actual method. There are two types of metallic coatings which are possible or which is mostly used, that is anodic coating and cathodic coating. Now coming to first anodic coating. Now the name itself indicates anodic coating means the if you can go through the this one right slide. If a coating metal is higher placed in galvanic series than the base metal, then the coating is called as anodic coating. We learnt about the what is meant by galvanic series, right? Which are the metal which behaves as anode, right? For example, the metals which are placed higher in the galvanic series, that is those metal, they behave as anode. Suppose a metal is coated with the metal with the other metal, that metal is placed higher in the galvanic series than the base metal. Understand, the base metal is lower placed whereas the coating metal is higher placed. So that process is called as anodic coating. For example, zinc, aluminum, chromium coated on steel, all this is an example of the anodic coating, right? And similarly, what will be now a cathodic coating? It will be reverse of anodic coating, right? Now the base metal will be anode and the coating metal will be cathode, right? Cathode means the coating metal will be placed below in the galvanic series, right? The metals which are below in the galvanic series are used for coating purpose. For example, a tin on steel or a silver on a gold or gold on brass, all these are the examples of cathodic protection or sorry cathodic coatings. Now which will be more preferred as per this one? Mostly, if the anodic coating is done, what will happen? If suppose base metal is acting as cathode and the coating metal is acting as anode, now the corrosion, if it starts, it will start only on the surface, right? Because the coating metal is on the surface, right? So as you know that anode will get corrode faster. So only the top part will get corroded and your base metal will remain intact for longer time. And if you use cathodic coating, what will happen? It will the corrosion will not start at the top that easily, but where it may start at the it will start on the base metal because it is behaving as anode. So which out of two will be more preferred? Now the anodic coatings are more preferred than the cathodic coatings because once the corrosion starts, it will just corrode the upper area or upper portion. It will not go inside or it will not percolate inside and it will not destroy the underlying metal. So anodic coatings are more preferred over cathodic coatings. This question is asked several times in the exam. What is mean by metallic coatings? What are the types of metallic coatings and which type of coatings are preferred and why, right? Which is preferred here now? Anodic coating. Why it is preferred? Because if the corrosion starts, only the upper surface gets corroded. The underlying metal remains intact for longer time. The same question we can also, it can be asked as a differentiate between the anodic coating and cathodic coating. Now I will just show on this slide. You can just browse through it and you can pause and you can read that. These are the simple things. These are the anodic coating. There are three different points which are mentioned on the in this slide. So now what are the methods by which we can apply these coatings? I am going to continue in the next session.